All Things Must Pass, George Harrison, 8LP Deluxe Box Set, arrived, gave the original LP, the three records a listen, got through the box set, and in this video I want to show you the content, talk a bit about the quality, about my personal things. I think about this box set, what I think about the content, what I think about the way of these kind of releases. Maybe we first start, of course, with the box set itself. It comes in a beautiful outer case. Did a great job, very nice, very beautiful. Can't do it much better in this price range. And it contains a lot. It contains the three disc original set. You have 5 LPs of demos, session outtakes, jam recordings, and stuff like that. You got a beautiful book where we go through in a minute. And we have the new mix from a guy called Paul Hicks, who is himself is a Grammy Award winner. Congratulations, great. And so that sounds not bad at all. So we start, you already have seen the outer case of this box set. We have this book, 60 page booklet. Let's go through it. Starts with a very cool, very nice photo of George Harrison. We go briefly through the content of the booklet. Got a lot of photos. I really like that kind of stuff. It's always great to have, to go through, see the pictures, read the text. Very nice, very good. Then you have really you have a ton of, as I said in the beginning, in this second part of the box set, you have also a nice outer sleeve, outer case, and here you have the demos from day one, day two demos, session outtakes and jams, which is very interesting, very nice to have. Archival stuff on five records. This is the way you open this box. You have this kind of inner sleeves, which are empty because the record itself or themselves comes in okay inner sleeves. I will change those against the vinyl storage solution ones, but they are okay. You can keep them in this case, of course, too. And then, of course, you have the All Things Must Pass 3-disc edition in this new mix. We also have the original poster that came also with the original release, I think. And as I said, you have the original LP here, 3-disc set, again with this kind of sleeves. And maybe the record itself, of course, it was the third release of George Harrison, which when it came out directly after the Beatles split up, it was a huge success. It was, I think, several time platinum in the USA alone. As I said, a huge success. Of course, if Harrison does his solo release right after the Beatles split up, of course, this is, of course, marketing, marketeer's dream come true. But it's also, and now it comes to my taste, it is one of those very, very good solo releases from the Beatles, this All Things Must Pass. It's a great album. Of course, you have your Phil Spector wall of sound. I don't want to go too deep into it because there are other Beatles freaks who goes very, very deep and knows so much about this release as I can't compete and I won't compete. So if you want to talk about All Things Must Pass as an music historical artifact, this is the wrong video. We talk about the box set itself, and in a way I want to focus a bit, now that I have shown you briefly the content, about the things I miss, what I would expect at least. And there are very good examples where we get that. I expect at least something like they did with the Brian Wilson remaster from the Gentle Giant album, where you get the Brian Wilson remix and you get the remaster, whatever, however you want to call it, and you get the original mix. Just to compare, I think this would be something good, that you compare what you have. And I mean, we are talking about huge releases. Imagine this Uber box set with George Harrison as a gardener, action figures, and also very, very beautiful books, by the way, what I've seen in Mez's video, fantastic books. But why not give us two versions of this album? I don't get it. Or what I would have loved to see is an real remaster, to be honest. To see a real remaster from people like Kevin Gray or Bernie Grundman, Ryan K. Smith. This would be something. Maybe even on this super silent great vinyl that we have nowadays, and which sounds fantastic. I mean, why not this direction too? You know, they go, it's like Disney World in a way. Don't get me wrong, those are great box sets and it's funny and nice. You get your original toenail from George Arno, you don't get that. But this is a bit Disney World, don't get me wrong. What I, of course, it's always personal, it's always personal taste. What I would have loved is a really cool audiophile remaster on audiophile vinyl. Why don't we get it? Probably because they keep their tapes like religious items, which is in my opinion such a stupid decision. Because if you let them rot in your vault, they are completely useless. In a way, they are like Schrödinger's cat. Why do I have to care about a cat when I can't see it? And same here. Okay, we have those tapes, but nobody can touch them. And that is the reason why we get mediocre releases from the Beatles and from their solo albums, at least their earlier one. I will never, ever get it. You know, when in a decade or two, those Beatles fanboys and fangirls will die like flies, and only a fraction of the people that are nowadays care for those releases will buy them. They have perfect tapes and only a few people care. Now the people do care. And I think now is the time to put out those releases and to remaster them in the standards we have reached today. I mean, if you can do it with Lee Morgan, why can't you do it with George Harrison? Come on. I will never get it. It's so stupid. And if you don't want them to leave it, Great Britain, okay, then give it over to the Electric Recording Company, let them run the tapes through their gorgeous Lyrex system, and we will get a fantastic release. Because, don't get me wrong, this this vinyl is dead flat, beautiful. I was lucky. No complaints here. It's okay. It's absolutely okay. It sounds okay. But okay is in my opinion, okay is not enough when you can do great. So leave your Disney World attitude and give us the best remaster versions that are possible. You know, if you see how popular this topic over at the Hoffman Forum is, how many people cares about these releases nowadays, or see how successful the video this about the Uber box set from Mezzi was. There are so many people who care about those releases. Give them this best possible quality. So